Hello and welcome to a typed Clojure screencast. And in this video, we're going to write an interpreter for some version of the Lambda calculus. Let's say we want to support functions. Let's say they're one argument functions, conditionals, and we want variables. And maybe a let binding. Okay, so we're going to type check this interpreter as we're writing it in Clojure with a typed Clojure. So the first thing we're going to do is require core.typed and check that everything's working. Okay, so I've got my own key binding for Vim. To type check this namespace, but if you're following along at home, just open up your REPL and call t/checkNS and it will check the current namespace, or you can pass it in a symbol. Alright, so what do we want? So the interpreter takes in some syntax and returns a value. But so commonly when you write an interpreter in Clojure, you usually have a few phases, like analysis phase, emission phase. So let's write the analyzer. So analyzer takes syntax, which will be our Lambda calculus, so this sort of syntax here, and it will return, let's say, a nested map representation for an abstract syntax tree. So let's call it analyze, and it takes some syntax and has some body. So with type Clojure, we can say that it takes any and returns some AST, and we can use a type alias to express what this AST is. So we know that this is going to be a recursive AST, so we use a recursive type. So it can either be a lambda, let's say it an operation of lambda, and it has a name for its argument and a body. So the name is going to be a symbol, and the body is going to be an AST node. Okay. So if we're going to say, going to have multiple cases, we can use a union type. So this AST is either a lambda AST node, or it's a conditional. So here, test is an AST, then is an AST, and else is an AST. So I forgot we also want numbers. Or just, yeah, let's keep it to numbers for now. So we also want local bindings. Let's say the local binding has a name, and let's just keep it to that for now. We can extend that if we need to. And let bindings, let's say we tag it as having a let operation. It has a name, an initial value for the name, which will be an AST node. Which is this B, and then the E will be the body. It's an AST node. And let's see if that type checks. So we've got a type error. This is pretty much what we want. At line 21, which is this line here, it says we're expecting an AST, so we actually got nil. Great. So let's start adding in the body here. And I'll turn off visual bell so my screen won't flash. Okay, so you can see the way we're going to dispatch between these AST nodes is with this op key. So we have to add an op key in every one of our AST nodes. But remember, the analyzer is going to return an AST, so we need to test on the structure of its input. So let's get the easy ones out of the way. So say if the syntax is a number, then we return All right, well, we haven't got this AST node, but let's make it up on the spot. It's an op, let's say it's a constant operation with value number. And we can add this to our union. And the value can be any. And let's say if it's a symbol, we can... No, symbols are special. Let's say if it's a keyword, then we have a constant keyword. Okay, so the our other expressions, aside from symbol, require us to have a list. So let's do the symbol case. Actually, before we do that, let's start some good practices and try and change our interpreter very incrementally and test as we go. So let's do something very simple. Let's type check, analyze the syntax one. We get back an AST node and we should be able to type check this as well. So we've got a type error. What's it saying? Yeah, right. So this is what we expect. We're actually getting HMAP or nil. So that's not part of an AST. So this is complaining that this can return nil. And of course it can, because if you go down the else branch here. So let's just say to keep core type happy, we'll throw an exception. Bad input syntax. This will help us run the type checker incrementally. Okay. And this should type check as well. No. It's a syntax. If it's keyword, we can analyze it. Okay. So if it's a symbol, then in this Lambda calculus, if it's a symbol, it's going to be a local binding. And we get an exception, bad input. So let's just comment that out for now. And what's the logical next step? Yes. Yeah, well, let's implement that now. So we've got our local AST node. If it's a syntax, if the syntax is a symbol like we have here, then we just say that it's a symbol, it's a local binding with name syn. And type check it. And this should, and that passes. So notice something interesting, that our local AST node has a symbol as a name, and core typed has followed the control flow and figured out that this syntax object here is actually a symbol, and we can actually check this in Vim. If you press in normal mode, lowercase c, capital K, you can see the type of the current symbol, and yeah, it's a symbol here. But if you see over here, it's of type any, and we've casted it implicitly to symbol. Okay, so if we run this, cool, that all works. That looks fine. Okay, so why not tackle Lambda? So it turns out we probably want a big dispatch on the first element of a list. So let's say if we've got a list, then we can... there's a couple of ways of doing this. Let's just do it this way. So if we have an if as the first of our syntax, then we can destructure it as having test then else. And I think we actually need one more test on this. Just because destructuring requires us to have a sequential thing, and this predicate doesn't exactly guarantee that we have a sequential thing. So core typed will actually complain if we try and destructure something that isn't sequential. Okay, let's clean this up a little bit. So if we have an if, then we have a test, then else. Let's also do some checking here. Let's assert that the count of the if of this syntax is 4. Otherwise, give some bad input error. Otherwise, we can keep going. Cool. So our if node, let's just split this screen so we can see. This is our if spec that we've made. So we want to return something in this shape. So we have an op key with if. The test is an analyzed AST. So we call analyze on the test. We call analyze on the then. And then analyze on the else. Oops. And let's add another check here. Okay, well, let's type check it first. Cool, so it type checks. Well, ship it. But no, okay, let's write a test instead. I don't know, well, if 1, 2, 3, what's this going to give us? This is pretty much what we're expecting. That's cool. Let's have some other nodes that have nested nodes inside them. So, Lambda. Let's use Lambda. Okay. So, if the first of the syntax is Lambda, then let's steal these lines. So Lambda has 1, 2, 3 nodes, bad input. Oop. Okay. So Lambda has a binding and a body. And the binding must be a vector. So we assert that B is a vector. You know what? This is getting annoying. Let's abstract out this check input. What's it going to take? Going to take syntax and a test. Is it going to work? I don't know. Assert test. Just comment this out for now. I can't think about whether this will work. Let's just check. Check input. Let's say we've got a 1 and nil. Okay, bad input 1. Cool. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, so let's say check input syn. And that's just a stupid function. Let's say bad input sin is the same as check input sin nil. Cool. That's a little easier to follow. Check. Oh. Alright, so I haven't touched the type checker in a little while. I'm not sure if it's going to complain. Cool, what's it saying? Type mismatch. Okay. Ah. So it doesn't know that these two throw exceptions. Ooh, yeah. Let's... Actually, it's easier just to go... yeah, I'm not sure why I did that. Let's say it's a string... bad input all right, let's try that again. Okay, so there's a nil being leaked out of this somewhere. Out of this cond. Whoop. It's not telling me where. Bad input. Well, I guess we can test these various expressions. That's returning nothing. Doesn't even get that far. Oh. My parens are all messed up. Cool. Let's check these alignment of parens. Okay, type checking. Wow, okay. It's happy now. Anyway, back to what we were doing. So, if the first element of our list is the symbol lambda, like this, then we have a binding and a body. We want to check... check the input there. This assert needs to be inlined because, yeah, type Clojure won't figure out that it's a vector. So, unfortunately, oh, actually, no. If we make check input a macro, then this will be just fine. So type Clojure just macro expands out any code and, you know, inlines it and then checks it. It doesn't try and predict macro expansion without expanding it. So by just putting the assert, it'll type Clojure can kind of follow the branching and figure out what the casts mean. Make sure I've got these quotes right. Assert, unquote, test, bad input. Why not just... that doesn't need to be... Yeah, type Clojure knows that will throw. Okay. So we're safe to check input. So now that we know that the binding is... So it needs to be a vector and it needs to have count one. Cool. So now we can get out the name. So our result, where's our node? Lambda. So it's got a name and an AST. So op lambda name. This also needs to be a symbol here. So the body has to be analyzed. Where's our body? Our body. So this body here. Okay. Let's test it before we type check it this time. So do we want it to be a vector? Let's leave it as a vector then. Okay, fine. All right, where are we? 66. Oh, whoa. Let's check syntax. Oh, this is a bad test. B. This is getting a bit unwieldy. See, I've already made like 3 mistakes in a few seconds. Oh well, we might refactor this out to be a bit less confusing later. Okay, so we've analyzed it to be a lambda and the local binding. Okay, cool. So we're not actually doing a check that this A is actually in scope. Let's say that the emitter does that at runtime, and we'll implement that as soon as we finish this. Okay, so we've actually got most of what we want. We've got if, lambda, let's implement let, and we should be done with the analyzer. So if it's let, then it has to be 3 elements long as before. So let's get out the binder and the body. Cool. And it's the same as this. Why not make it a vector again, except it's 2-place vector. And let's say there's a binder and a right-hand side. And the left-hand side must be a symbol. And then we return again, what are we returning? A name init body. Cool. Name is our symbol. The init is analyzing the right hand side. The body is analyzing the body. And we'll type check that. Okay, it was happy. All right, so this cond is pretty awful. Let's make it a case and do a case on the first. So we can just do let lambda if type check that again. Okay. So let's make sure that we didn't break anything. Let's do these crude tests. So let a one a. Yeah, that looks fine. It'll be much easier to test this once we have an emitter. So let's build our emitter. So we have a way to go from syntax. It might be easier to read if we make an alias for syntax, which is just any. So analyze goes from syntax to AST. Emit goes from AST to any. No. Yes. It'll go from AST to a evaluatable closure form, and then we can pass that form through a val. So let's do that, and then a val will obviously return some closure value. So the end goal is that we can do some lambda expression, pass it to analyze, then to emit, and then a val, and then we can get our runtime value for that lambda calculus expression being evaluated. But yeah, so we've got analyze, a val is already there. Let's write emit. Get rid of that. Emit. So emit takes in an AST and returns. Let's call this lambda calculus syntax, and this is closure syntax. So takes in lambda calculus syntax. And this takes in closure syntax. Clearly, that none of these aliases do anything other than document. We could say that this is an expression in lambda calculus. Make sure I spelled that correctly. A closure expression. Cool. Emit. So it takes an AST, returns closure syntax. So it takes an AST. Now, this would be nicer implemented as a multi-method. So let's do that. So emit takes in an AST and then dispatches on its op key. And we've seen all the possible op keys, lambda, if, local, let, const. Okay. So we can go def. Let's just type check this just to make sure type closure's keeping up with us, even though it might take 6 or 7 seconds. Okay. So, well, let's just take the first one. Def method emit lambda. So we're in this method, we know we've got a lambda expression, so we can destruct it. It's got a name and a body. And the closure representation of this is it's a fun with a name and the body, and we emit the body, right? And to actually unit test this, let's write some leaf nodes. I think const is a good one. Const just has a value and returns its value. So we can do things like, we need application to test the lambda. Oh no, we could still look at the syntax. So for example, we could go lambda a returns 1, analyze it, and then emit it, and we should get something. No emit for lambda. Have I not evaluated this buffer? Okay, so yeah, there's the syntax that we're expecting. So we're getting a fun A1. Cool. And we could evaluate this. Of course, there's no application, so it's not going to help. But, you know, we could... What if we call list here? Could we get back one? I can't quite think. I think it's apply list or... I think this should get us back one. Nope. Can't figure it out. Let's just write what we're going to write. So let's... Oh, I don't even have an application in this. Okay, well... Let's write application after we've done all these other cases. So if we've got an if, we have a test, then an else. Which is just simple translation. Oops. Let's see. So if we have an if, 1, 2, 3, and let's not eval it. Yeah, we should get back if 1, 2, 3. That doesn't surprise me. Let's do lambda a1. Cool. This is looking good. All right, so we've got if local. Let's do local. So local is pretty easy. We just omit the actual name. So if we have something like lambda xx. We should be able to get back. So this would be, this would hit our local case. It's been a while since we've type checked. Let's just, I think I've got it right so far, but might as well type check it. Okay. So again, type closures can follow this control flow. So if it's in a lambda, it knows that this is a symbol, this is an AST, therefore it's safe to pass to emit. And so it can follow this logic in the same way it followed the cond above, or the case statement. So we just write the closure code as normal. So what's up next? Let. Let's write let. Let init body with let, it's just name emit init emit body evaluate that. What's that gonna look like? No, I still want that quote there. Let's say a. It would be nice to have a function application, but okay, let works. Constants, have we done constants? Yes, so we've done constants. Let's type check this entire thing and then add application nodes so we can actually have real programs. Cool. So, as before, let's do a bit of design work. So, we're going to have an application node. I guess let's just call it app. We have an operator and an operand. And since we've only got functions of one argument, let's leave it at one argument applications. So, somewhere in here. So it's going to have to be on this. Oh, this case. Oh, that's nasty. Yes, so this is perfectly valid Clojure code, but there's a bug here. See, look, I'm dispatching on the first thing, and then case takes pairs of things, and then there's this else. So this case is going to return nil. No. If case drops off, does it return nil? No, it... Oh, it needs a thing. Case nil. Yes, okay, no, that's fine. This will... Okay, it coincidentally will do the right thing, but you can see that this is clearly not what we want. It needs to be this. It returns bad input if it falls through. But we've actually got another case. We don't want this line here. So perhaps the case here wasn't such a good idea. There's a couple ways we can do this. Let's just do another cond as the base case. If it's a list and it's sequential and it is of length 2, then we create an application node operator, which is the first thing analyzed, and operand, which is the second thing, and then the base case can be bad input. All right, let's just write a little test for that. What did I just implement? Okay, so lambda x. A1. No matching clause A. What is this doing? Maybe type checking will help. Let's just comment out this and type check. Nope, it's all good. Alright, let's some gorilla debugging then. Oh, it just fixed itself. Amazing. Who would have thunk it? I forgot to evaluate the buffer. Excellent. All right, that's good. And let's have a corresponding test down here. Lambda XX, reply A to 1. This isn't going to work yet because we need to add an application. Emission. So we have a... Whoops. Rater rand. And it's just a list. We could just say map emit over rater rand. And this returns a list, so it'll be fine. Cool. And if we evaluate this, we should get 1. 1. Yay! Alright, so type checking time. What does type Clojure think? Cool, it likes it. All right, so we've built a Clojure style interpreter. We've got an analyzer, an emitter, and we've gone from Lambda calculus to Clojure syntax and then evaluated it. So we'll leave this here for now. Next time, maybe we'll extend it to be a simply typed Lambda calculus, and we'll write a little type checker and type check the implementation with type Clojure. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.